Very Merry Christmas. A Happy New Year. I'm not telling anybody where I'm going to spend New Year because then they'll all show up. But the coach is going to be kicking it in H-Town, baby. Houston, Texas is where the coach is going to be for New Year's.
Unbelievable. You have so many women. How do you juggle them all, coach? It is beyond me.
Sometimes I feel like I'm in the circus.
Well, right now, Val Venus going head-to-head against Chad Collier, coach. Do we know much, if anything, about Chad Collier?
Well, we really don't. We know that this kid is tough from what we understand. He's a tremendous in-ring performer, and I think that he may give Val Venus a serious run for his money here tonight.
Well, just by his physical look, he's obviously in shape, but not nearly the size of the big Valboski. But still trying to rough him up and look at Val.
You can see and hear.
That's not going
to
work.
You know how tough it is to get the upper hand on one of these two guys. But speaking of the upper hand, I think you want to talk about this right now. I know I do. This past week on Raw, somewhat controversial, I guess, if you want to say that. But at the same time, very entertaining, the fact that Mick Foley came back on Raw last Monday night.
Well, Mick Foley came out to salute the troops and to let everyone know that he would be appearing in the Middle East when WWE presents Holiday Tribute to the Troops this Thursday on SmackDown. A great honor for Foley and for all the superstars who were headed over there. But there were a couple of men who weren't too happy about this trip, Coach.
Well, yeah.
Muhammad Hassan. And his general manager is...
I mean, I guess you could call him that, Daivari. I mean...
backslide. Hold on. No, 2 count.
I mean, these guys came out and they completely contradicted...
Another count, no.
Everything Mick Foley was speaking about, was talking about, stood for, saying they used to blindly support the USA. Used to blindly support the United States troops, but not anymore. They said it's a war that's unjust, a war that shouldn't be happening. Like I said, somewhat controversial, but as Mick Foley said, at least they're in a country where they can voice their opinion.
Absolutely. Foley disagreed, but said, hey, thanks to our Constitution, you can say whatever you want, and there's nothing we can do about it. Certain countries in the world, including some in the Middle East, were not given that right.
But, you know, I don't want to say funny, but it was surprising that Mick Foley invited Muhammad Hassan into the ring, but Hassan said he would not fight Foley because he didn't respect Foley. I don't know too many people that don't respect Foley. I know some guys that don't like him.
It may have been a cop-out.
Well, it could be.
Nobody wants to get in a ring with Mick Foley because Mick Foley does not back down from anyone. And right now, Val Venus is having all kinds of trouble with Chad Collier.
Well, we talk about being technically sound, and I think you're seeing right now, you can see the agony on the face of Val Venus. The last time I saw that much agony on the face of Val Venus was when, like, the third, fourth, and fifth chick of the night kept turning him down at the club. You know what I'm talking about?
Well, I know you're joking, but this is all serious right here. Val Venus is in big trouble.
Well, yeah, because he's underestimating the talent of Chad Collier.
A couple of shots, and look at those. And now a right hand, and Val Venus putting up no defense. Here's a little bit, a face of the turnbuckle, and Val Venus delivering a few chops of his own. And look at those chops. Collier wisely gets out of the ring.
Collier saying that's enough, or so we thought. And instead, continuing the attack, continuing the aggressive nature on Val Venus.
Well, it's no secret. In order to be successful in the WWE, you gotta pick out a spot on your opponent and work at it and work at it and work at it. And it appears Chad Collier has decided to hone in on that left leg of Val Venus.
And I think everybody here, especially guys that are with the WWE full-time or even guys like Chad Collier, are trying to make a name for himself, establish himself as we head towards the new year. And we've got two huge events coming up. We've got
a smart package. Butt roll up the window.
In the month of January, of course, we've got New Year's Revolution, the first pay-per-view event in San Juan, Puerto Rico,
January 9th.
And we've got the Royal Rumble as well. So a huge month in January.
Absolutely. And let's not forget that Lita told Gene Snitsky this past week on Raw, a backbody drop there by Val Venus, that Kane would be coming back looking for Snitsky.
Kane's coming back. Now, keep in mind, we don't know when, we don't know where, but we know Kane's coming back.
Oh. A snap suplex for the win! No!
And the number one person at the top of the Big Red Monsters list is that ugly, ugly man, but a dangerous man in Gene Snitsky.
Yeah, I don't think the Divas liked him too much. What do you think? Christy, not the number one Gene Snitsky fan right now?
They don't call him Divas for nothing, kid. They don't like much of anybody. And that's the truth.
Val Venus, despite having that left leg worked on by Chad Collier is deciding to go up to the top rope. Not perhaps the wisest of moves, and Chad Collier, with an impressive drop kick, sends Valvinus down.
Well, say it like it is. It's an absolute mistake. I've said it before, you have to stay on top of your opponent. If you don't, if you try to go for the high-risk maneuver to end things quickly, more often than not, it's not the right move.
Again, Chad Collier working that leg, and Valvinus,
wait, just stop it out. He just tapped out.
I don't think he did, Coach. He didn't tap out.
Hey, Mike Chioda, referee Mike Chioda, Valvinus just tapped out. Ring the bell.
No, he didn't. Valvinus came close to tapping out, but I didn't see him tap the mat. He may do it here, though. Valvinus in all kinds of pain. Mike Chioda asking Val, does he want to give up?
You want to give it up?
Is he going to quit?
Of course he's going to quit. This one's over.
He wants that bottom rope in the worst way.
Merry freaking Christmas.
He got it. Valvinus had one way out. It was to reach the bottom rope, and he did it.
Well, but you can see that Valvinus is hardly even going to be able to stand on both legs, let alone one.
Chad Collier showing perhaps some inexperience, arguing with the referee. Perhaps your point, Coach, that Valvinus did
tap out.
Well,
there you go. Well, he did tap out, and now he's taking so much damage to that left leg, he couldn't even get Chad Collier up for a suplex.
Oh, and look at this, a sleeper from Collier. Valvinus is getting all he can handle here from Chad Collier. Gets him up. Will that leg stand up? It does. A spinebuster from Venus. Will it do it? It will. Venus pulls a win out of nowhere.
Pulls a win after pulling a thigh muscle.
Venus.
Well, Valvinus got off.